Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to the presentation of the Surprising Christmas Pageant. We appreciate you being here tonight. For those of you who do not know me, my name is Tim Kennedy, and I am the Director of Youth and Children's Ministries here at Archdale Church. And I've got a little something that, doing a little reading ahead this week in our new devotional, I ran across, we've got some kids coming in, by the way, so they told me to talk while they came in, so we've got a devotional, and I went ahead and read ahead, and this Friday's devotional seemed just befitting of tonight's performance. So if you don't mind, we're going to read this. It's from our own Diane Cabot. Christmas Eve at my childhood church near Thomasville meant a paper bag stuffed full of fruits, nuts, and candy. Under the oversized Christmas tree was a bag for each child present. That was back in the days when church Christmas trees were real. The scent of those evergreens was so powerful that when I concentrate really hard, I can still smell them today. And I can almost see the bathrobe young shepherds and the tinsel trim wings of the angels who play in our annual Christmas pageant. My memories of that evening are all about the sweet taste, sights, sounds, and smells that were Christmas for a small child growing up in an earlier time. As I look back, I realize that I had taken this whole scene for granted. I simply knew the treats, and the tree would be there. And so the beautiful, if amateurish, reenactment of that holy night when God came to dwell among us. It never occurred to me that someone, many someones actually, worked long and hard, making costumes and producing the set. I never thought about the ones who had tromped through the woods to select and cut down the perfect tree, or the people who spent hours decorating it. Nor did I consider who might have purchased or bagged those fruits, nuts, and candies. It was all a part of the most exciting evening of the year. And I never gave a single thought of what all of it had cost someone in terms of time and money. And yet some folks had spent a lot of time in preparation for that night of nights when we would come together as a church family and celebrate the birth of our Savior. I wrote down a long list of names down the side of this to thank them tonight. But as I looked through the program and realized they are printed, and also realized that these people have done what they do out of love for Christ and love for these children. Rather than read these list of names, you all have them printed in front of you. Thank them, hug their necks, for the ministry to these children. I would also like to thank these children for all the rehearsals they came to. I tell you, they spent quite a few times having to sit still and be quiet, a lot more often than they really like to. So let's give everybody involved a big round of applause. And now we will present the Surprising Christmas Pageant.
In the name of our Lord Jesus Christ, and on behalf of Archdale Methodist Church, I welcome you to this celebration of the birth of our Savior. First, a question. How many of you brought cameras today? Very good. Here's a chance to test them. Thank you. We would ask you not to use your cameras during the pageant. People will be entering and exiting through the aisles, so we have to keep the aisles clear. Also, the flashbulbs temporarily blind the performers, and if they can't see a step or bump into someone, they could get hurt up here. Okay. You will have a chance to take pictures after the pageant. We have an official pageant photographer. mountains. But don't you try this. You'll have a chance afterward. I promise. Now your Christmas party. Shopping now? 600 years before we built the
and you should call his name Jesus.
I was less scared when I thought you were an alien.
Look, next time I'll move, I'll make sure I know the difference between an alien and an angel.
Great, thanks. And when you come back?
Yes.
Could you be a good way to explain this to my husband?
Thank you. This rocking chair, you know what it would be good for?
No.
Let's say I'm holding a baby and the baby's crying. I sit, I rock, and sing, and the baby goes to sleep.
You would do that?
I'd be happy to.
Who could that be?
Well, Mr. Joseph, the reason that there are animals
Yes.
The reason is with all our animals, aren't it? Animals.
All of them?
Oh, yes. First of all, yes. We're having a really advantage of our creatures.
They do?
Oh, yes, they do. So you can use a glimmer or a lime, and we can have to do home through the windmill.
Oh. Well, I wouldn't have brought it up, except my wife just had a baby.
A baby? Congratulations. Boy or girl?
Boy.
And a little fellow's name?
Jesus.
Wonderful. That would be another 359.
359?
Thank you.
when we do. They'll find a baby in a manger.
He said so. Yes, a manger. Glory to God in the highest and on earth. Peace, good will be.
Thank you. We are wise people from the east, and we seek the newborn king. King, you know, regent, and above, we are here.
Marion gives in trouble for.
Over field and fountain, moor and mountain,
falling beyond their star.
When they had heard the king, they went on their way, and lo, the star they had seen in the east went before them till it came to rest over the place where the child was. When they saw the star, they rejoiced exceedingly with great joy, and going into the house, they saw the child with Mary his mother, and fell down and worshipped.
And that's how the story ends.
The story doesn't end. God's grace and love for us isn't 2,000 years old. It's new every day. It may appear in ways we don't accept or in things we see every day, but it's always there.
I know I said all the time.
Yes.
But could we tell us one more time?
Okay, one more time.
Thanks once again for coming. I'm standing on the cord, sorry. Thanks again for coming. We have another special surprise for the children who are 12 years old and younger. We have done treat bags. And so some of our youth are going to hand those out to you guys before you leave. Any kids in the audience are welcome to go on over there as you leave and get them. All you guys can have one, but guess what? You have to go in there and take off your clothes, I mean your costumes. Just the costume part. And then you can get your treat bags, okay? I've already instructed the youth, if you show up in a costume, don't give you one. Save it for me. Thanks once again, and everyone, Merry Christmas.